offensive.
Well, you would not have been. Well, we would have given you one mouthful with Nick Mangold's great, great barbecue sauce. Let's bring in Nick right now. Nick, you are all cool with this, helping Peter to get down some crickets with your great barbecue sauce, right?
Well, they would have been the best crickets that I think anyone's ever eaten.
That's
obviously,
right.
With the sauce on it. So it really wouldn't have been that much of a punishment. I think it actually
Thank
probably
you.
Would have been more of a reward.
See?
How good is this? Now, this is supposed to be available for purchase on March 21st. Is that still the deal?
Yes. Luckily, we had our shipment went out. We were in production before everything got a little crazy in this world. So we're really excited about it. 74BBQ. .com is where you can find it. It'll be online sales to start, and hopefully we'll get into grocery stores in the tri-state area as soon as possible.
Anything
now, also,
about
this
yours?
Is going to help New York City police and firefighters, right?
Yeah, so a portion of our proceeds is going to answer the call, which helps out the families of fallen firefighters and police officers who have fallen in the line of duty. So they do some amazing work. And so this was an opportunity for me. I've been working with them for, it's been five years or so. And so now this has something where I can have a continual opportunity to be a part with them and to really give back.
Where did this idea come from? Not just the charitable part, but just the barbecue sauce in itself.
Yeah, we know you like wine. We didn't know you like barbecue sauce.
Well, they go hand in hand, of course. So this started, my wife, being as sneaky as she is, got me a big green egg one Father's Day many years ago. And we had a offensive lineman, Ron Heller, as our assistant offensive line coach. He came in. He's a certified barbecue judge. And he got me into the barbecue world. And it just grew from there. And this was something I was making for friends and family at the house. I wanted the opportunity after I got done playing to create. You know, I've never really created anything other than I'd probably say my four kids. But this gives me the opportunity to build something, to share it with them, because barbecue, there's something special about barbecue, the way that it brings people together and have good stories and good food. And so this is how, you know, I want to be spreading that love out to the world.
What's your favorite kind of barbecue? Are you a Kansas City guy, Texas guy? Where's your favorite barbecue?
I'm a New Jersey guy. My backyard is my favorite. I like it all. You know, as I've dabbled around, my wife and I have a big argument over pulled pork. I like a pulled pork a little bit more of a Texas style, and she's a Carolina pulled pork. So we get in arguments all the time, but it's awesome to be able to see the different regions and to see what they create and be able to share it with everybody.
Two flavors, the OG, sweet with a touch of heat, and spicy sweet with a whole lot of heat. Which one do you prefer?
So I'm original to start off, but and that's kind of where it's interesting. This is part of my whole evolution of the barbecue sauce is I'm hoping that at some point I will get to have four sauces out there, one for each of my children. So right now we have the OG, which is for my first son, and then the spicy OG, which is for my second son because he's like a carbon copy except more of a firecracker. And then for my two daughters, I'm hoping to have sweet style sauces coming out. So I want to get this thing going for that connection with the kids.
Very cool. And again, give the website where people can order this.
So it's 74 spelled out 74bbq.com.
How strange is it?
Good luck with
you. Yeah, definitely. Good luck. That sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun. And the charitable aspect of it too, man. You've always been cool that way.
Oh, well, I appreciate it. Thank you.
How strange is it as a former Jet to see Tom Brady finally gone and that you're not playing and taking advantage of it?
No, it kind of stinks. The 11 years I was with him, he was there. But it's crazy to think, you know, Tom Brady not being in New England. I didn't think it was actually going to happen. I figured the two sides would come together. Or he would throw us all for a curveball and just end up retiring. But to see him continue playing and not being in a New England jersey is going to be weird.
Now, do you think he made the right choice if it's in fact Tampa Bay?
Who knows, when you go to these you know, shooting for one. I mean, how many more years does he have left? You know, 1 or 2 years. Right. And you're trying to shoot for, you look at like Brett Favre, and, you know, he got close to doing it, but he, you know, obviously didn't win the Super Bowl. You know, is it worth it? You know, I don't know. And that's something that I don't think any of us are ever going to know.
Age-old question.
You know, what gets me, and I'm wondering about this, I said it earlier, and you could speak to this better than any of us, but, you know, there might be some curtailment of you know, any kind of camp, training camp, because of the coronavirus. And, I mean, it's going to be hard for a guy 20 years in one system to all of a sudden learn another one, even if the coach, Bruce Arians, is so quarterback-friendly. This can't be easy, Nick.
It really can. That's going to be very interesting, you know, watching it, the way that Tom has obviously been had his hand in the offense for the past 20 years, going to a new system and going to new teammates, even down to the point of a new cafeteria, a new locker room, a new way to get to the weight room. It's all going to be a new experience, and if it is shortened with everything that we have going on, it's going to be – it's going to take a little while to get that figured out, and I don't think that obviously is not going to help him.
This might be an easier question to answer a couple of years from now, but as of right now, who needed who more, Bill or Tom?
See, the age-old question, I love it because I don't know, and I think one of the biggest things that I think really fueled what's going on is that both of them think it's themselves. And so I think Bill wanted to prove that he can do it without Tom, and Tom obviously wants to prove that he can do it without Bill. But I think it's the combination of both of them. I think it's the perfect storm of them being together that made that all possible. And it'll be, you know, obviously a lot easier to answer 5 years down the road. But right now, I think they both need each other.
Talking with Nick Mangold, the former Jet, has new barbecue sauce out. He's very, very busy these days. So you watched games last year. You watched Brady. Do you think that Brady took a precipitous drop, or did he not have the weapons?
I don't think he had the weapons. I think he was still slinging the ball around. But, again, it's not, you know, 5 years ago, Brady. You know, everyone, the game is undefeated when it comes to age. And so everyone declines. And, you know, it'll be interesting to see how much going to a new team, if that gives him a spark, or if the decline, you know, grows faster.
Now, if the Jets don't do anything else other than take advantage of the draft, I mean, how do you feel about them going forward?
You know, they're looking good. You know, they seem to be prudent about what they're doing in free agency, not making any major splashes, you know, trying to build around. I saw they picked up a center, and which I'm always partial to those guys. So, you know, I think they're trying to build around the offensive line. And, you know, that seems to be the direction that I was hoping that they would go. And that's what it's looking like so far.
You still miss playing or not? Are you over it?
I don't miss playing. I don't miss waking up feeling miserable. I miss the game. I still love the game. You know, I miss the locker room, miss the guys. But otherwise, you know, I enjoy watching it from afar.
Now, in this time of uncertainty in our country, are you one of these people like I am? You just staying in your house?
Yeah, my wife has us on lockdown for no specific reason other than all the news that she reads and sees. So we've just been here hunkered down with the kids. The worst part is that she won't let the babysitter come over. So
Well, your wife is smart.
Yeah, I don't know. I could use a couple hours. But otherwise, you know, it's just been trying to keep it as normal for them as best we can now that we're trying to figure out how to homeschool.
Yeah, that's the toughest part. Anyway, go out and don't go out. Order online, 74bbq.com. You'll also be helping people who need the help, and you can help launch Nick Mangold's new barbecue sauce, which is available for purchase on March 21st. Good luck with this, Nick.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thanks for having me on, guys.
You got it.
Stay safe.
Have a good one.